was the year 1858, April the 28th to be exact. It was the day a person by the name of Pieter Jan Geurts would meet his own demise. What happened way back in the 1800s? Well, apparently Mr. Geurts thought it was a good idea to rape and kill a 6-year-old girl. No specific details are known since it's a very obscure old case from my home country, the Netherlands. But for historical reasons, I figured I'd share the little information there is. Now, Geurts was working a normal day job at the time of the crime. The victim in question was the 6-year-old daughter of his own boss. Rumor has it that after committing his gruesome crime, his boss, the victim's father, went insane. He never recovered. The details of what happened to his little girl made such an impact, it cost him his sanity. Well, who can blame him? I can't speak from experience and I hope you can't either, but it must be a very, very hard thing to face. Knowing what happened to your daughter and knowing it was done by someone you originally trusted and had worked within your company. On the 17th of December 1857, Geurts was found guilty of raping and murdering the 6-year-old daughter of his boss and was sentenced to death. Of course, like many murderers, he tried to appeal the conviction. He thought maybe there was a chance they overturned my death penalty. Just so you know, the death penalty has long since been abolished in the Netherlands. Now the highest conviction would be to serve life in prison. But back in the 1800s, we, like many other countries, still indulged in that form of punishment. Ultimately, the king denied the appeal. When the suspect learned about this, he cried like a little baby. I guess he was afraid, but at the same time, he seemed to have been accepting of his own fate as well, since they did ask how he felt about the conviction being followed through on, and his response was, "Well, I deserve to die, but I do want people to know I feel deep regret and sorrow for what I have done." They also described that he received some counseling from what would have been a Catholic priest at the time. An interesting little detail is that they said this priest found the situation so gruesome and hard to work with that he himself ended up terribly ill and almost dying in the process of assisting this murderer on his final days before his execution. When the fateful day finally arrived, it was the 28th of April, 1858. Geurts was crying and being walked towards the gallows. Before he got hanged, he was able to give one final hug to a statue of Christ. Then the noose was tying around his neck and his final words were, "I am prepared to die." As the floor opened underneath his feet, he didn't die instantly. Witnesses have stated for at least a few minutes it seems as if he was still alive and simply was slowly suffocating to death. There you go, some Dutch crime history for you. As always, dear viewer, have sweet dreams.